Finally, ultimately, every person they marry, it's their final choice. We said forced marriages are not allowed in Islam. How important is sincerity in every aspect in my life? Intention, sincerity. I mean, that's a topic in Islam. We could do a talk on sincerity. Sincerity, the first hadith of Sahih al-Bukhari, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. You know, very important. But remember, I don't know where the question is coming from, but maybe, you know, sometimes people think that, remember in Islam, the internal and external, both are important. You know, sometimes we have this extreme. Some people think, look at the spirit of Islam. You know, what's all these external rules? Islam, Allah says, وَلَدُ وَظَاهِرَ الْإِثْمِ وَبَاطِنَ. You have to avoid the external sins, you have to avoid the internal sins. You know, you can't just say, okay, my heart is clean, but then I can do whatever I want. You can't, it's not allowed in Islam. Just like, you know, externally, you know, avoiding certain things, but your heart is evil, that's wrong. Likewise, you know, thinking that your heart is clean, but it doesn't matter externally, no. Both are important. We have to avoid zahir and batin. We need to adorn our external and internal. Externally, how we act as Muslims, how we behave. There are rules in Islam. Because if you start looking at the spiritual side, then you might just, you know, avoid salah. So, my heart is always connected to Allah. I don't need to have a problem with this. People have actually gone that road. I know people who actually said this. That, you know, we're very spiritual, you know, we're just so spiritual. Our heart is 24/7 immersed in the love of the Almighty. And therefore, Fajr time, we're in our bed, you know, in the love of Allah. Immersed in the love of Allah in our bed. We are meditating. The room is dark, the lights are off, we are inside our, you know, quilt. Immersed in meditating. People feel, you know, say things like that. We're seeing dreams of Allah. We don't need to go Fajr. No, that's not reality. Another question, how would you approach your prospective spouse? There are ways and means, get people involved, don't do things yourself. Involve family or friends, or at least have third person in the middle. At least, if you're, for example, exchanging emails, then have it, you know, CC to someone, you know, like have someone else, someone in the middle. Every email that you're exchanging with your brother and sister, both the content and the manner has to be appropriate, as I discussed in the talk. And number two, have someone in the middle. So you know every email that you send, the other person is reading as well. Send it through someone. You will avoid a lot of harm, inshallah. What is Islam's view on modern-day homosexuals? That's a topic of Islam. Of course, we're talking about marriage here. Marriage between two men and two women is not allowed in Islam. It doesn't recognize it. So, you know. So another topic, maybe sometime, homosexuality, of course, Islam's opinion is that it's unlawful. It's simple. Just one thing here. I don't know. Time is short. Okay, leave it for another time. I don't want to go into zero. I don't know what this question is. Okay, so question starts from here. If love does not come before marriage, then can you please explain what the Prophet meant when he said there is nothing better for two who love one another than marriage? That's the exact hadith I ended my talk with. There is nothing that creates the meaning of the hadith, which is in the Sunan of Imam ibn Majah. Nothing creates love between two people than marriage. You know, there's nothing that the bond is created between two foreign people, marriage. Yes, there are other types of love as well. And there are different types of loves. Love is aqsam. Love between, you know, a love that a person has for his children. Love that you have for your parents. Love that you have for Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Love that you have for your spouse. These are different types of loves. Is it permissible for a married woman to work night shifts when she is alone with a male colleague? No, we said. Whether married or not married, not just a married woman. Married or not married, if you are working in a situation where it's khalwa, technically speaking, alone with a male colleague, in a place where a third person is not easily able to enter, you know, you're by yourself and you don't know who's going to enter the whole night, for example, right? It's haram, it's sinful. You have to avoid. Try and look for alternative job, inshallah. Will I give you an alternative job despite the global economic crisis? Many have asked me, so what's so wrong with dating? How do I answer them? Just playing my talk where I just gave to you right now. I talked about this. What advice would you give to practicing sisters who fear Allah yet claim to be in love? SubhanAllah. Love, maybe love with Allah is messenger. The practicing sisters, they claim to be in love, maybe they claim to be in love with Allah and Messenger. If they're claiming to be in love with somebody of the opposite gender and they're not married, then they're not really practicing love. They're just like I started my talk. Do you take parts of Islam? Allah said, "Udkhulu fi silmi kafa," enter into Islam fully. Don't become a half-time Muslim. Are the rules of khalwat the same in chat rooms, MSN, Facebook? Yeah, that's right as well. Yeah, good question. There are rules, seclusion. It's not as the level when you're physically alone, right? Physically alone. But there are rules as well. Like for example, you're having a conversation on the phone. Now for example, you're at home, you're by yourself, there's nobody else listening to you on the line. That is a type of khalwat. Now that, as long as the conversation is appropriate, and as long as you feel confident that you will not commit a sin, you will not fall into something haram, and shaitan will not mislead you, in of itself, having a conversation is permissible. We have to do it day to day life. We pick up the phone, you know, some electricity company, say hello, you have to talk. You know, the women there, the men there, you have a man, a woman talking to a man, you call your bank, you know, we're talking. I mean, we have to talk. So on the phone, or even if it's, maybe in a chat room, but you have to be very careful in Facebook and MSN messaging and chat rooms. You have to be extremely careful. So it's not as the actual physical khalwa, but it's still, you have to be very, very careful. And finally, you said to lower gaze for both men and women, but how can we do it when we communicate while looking at each other? There are rules about lowering the gaze. What's absolutely haram is lustful gaze, right? That's absolutely haram. So looking at the opposite gender with shahwa, with desire, with lust, in an evil way, in a way of, you know what I'm talking about. So that's definitely you have to avoid. But if you just without that, you feel confident in yourself, then there are rules that you can, maybe you can see. But especially for sisters, I mean, some of the scholars, like some of the schools of thought, I think the Hanafi school states, for example, there are different schools, the Shafi'i, Imam Malik, Imam Ahmad, Muhammad, and the great scholars of Ummah. There are slight differences, but some of them state that for a sister to look at a man is generally permissible. That's what we have. You know, somebody asked me when you have talks, right? All the sisters, I mean, they're looking at me right now. It's generally permissible. This is what, especially the Hanafi school states. It's permissible. Not for the vice versa, because men, right? You know what happens to the men. So it's evil. Right? So generally, sisters is permissible. Unless, for a sister, I'm going really deep fiqh ruling now. Unless, I mean, that's not really what I do in the public forum, but unless if the sister really feels inclined and she has desire and she looks in a lustful way, then she needs to avoid it. So it's really, for sisters, it's generally more lenient. For brothers, you do it from the other side. Default, generally, you will have a lustful look, right? Unless you're sure and confident that, there's nothing, it's just like looking at my own sister and my mother, there's nothing, I feel nothing, right? Then it's okay. So with the sisters, it's by default, it's okay, unless you feel absolute desire. And for the brothers, it's default is you will have some desire unless you feel absolutely sure that you're not going to do it from our own shop. صلى الله خير على المسكين استغفر الله وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم السلام عليكم